In this video, we are going to take a look at OpenAI's Assistant API. We will create an assistant that speaks the way we want and generates answers based on the files we provide. It is incredible how fast and easy it is to get started, but as you will see, there are some limitations along the road. My idea here is to create an assistant that has access to all my videos and can answer questions about them and also to link any video it mentions. Let's get started. The first step is to go to platform.openai.com. I'm already logged in and I'm at the playground. I have assistants selected and I need to press create. So first I have to enter a name. I call this one keycodesGPT, and then it wants to have a prompt. Basically the system prompt it uses to act the way we want it to act. You are keycodesGPT, an assistant with the knowledge about the YouTube channel keycodes. Rules. Number one, only use the provided context. I use this to limit hallucination. Second, always address the user with coder. Third, always ask anybody to like and subscribe. Four, end any message with have a lot of fun, coders. So I save this. I select the GPT-4 Turbo Preview model and save. So let's see what it does. Hello, who are you? Hello coder, I'm an assistant here to provide information about the YouTube channel Key Codes. Whether you are looking for programming tips, tutorials or insight into the world of software development, I am here to help you out. Please don't forget to like and subscribe for more coding content. Have a lot of fun, coders. Alright, that works so far. What videos does Key Codes have? Key Codes has a variety of videos that revolve around coding and software development. You can expect to find tutorials for different languages. Can you tell me the name of one of the videos? Apologies, coder, but as an AI developed by OpenAI, I don't have real-time access to the current YouTube content. So, as expected, the assistant has no idea what videos I make. Let's change that. To do that, I got all the audio from my videos. And I used a Python script here to open all the audio files and send it to the Whisper API. And the result is then saved into transcript files you see here. Let's open one. Today I want to talk to you about 5 habits that you can adopt right now. That's a video of mine. Then I took all these transcripts and I added some metadata to all of it, like the YouTube URL and the title of the video. And I used this to generate a couple of files. For instance, I got this file here, which includes the video title, the video URL, and the transcript. Or I have the same as a JSON file, as a beautified JSON, and so on. Let's see if we can use that to give our assistant some knowledge about my videos. The first thing I try is to upload the text format file, so not the JSON, this one. And I need to activate retrieval so that it can access this file. Save. Now I clear the context and try again. Can you tell me a name of a video from the channel? Okay, it doesn't access the files yet. So maybe we need to adjust our prompt. I add only provide links that you find in the documents provided. Hopefully this way we don't get links that aren't existing and the model actually knows that there are documents to look at. Clear. Can you tell me if Key Codes has a video about type-ins? Yes, Key Codes has a video titled Why You Should Use Type-ins in Python. Are type-ins worth it? You can watch it on YouTube. This is the link. Okay, is it though? Let's try it. It is. Very nice. Good. That was easy. Let's try more. Can you list all the videos about Git commits? Key Codes has made a video that covers the topics of Git commits titled How to Use Git Hooks. Okay, but there is one video I have as well. There must be one called How to Commit Better with Git. Run failed. Okay, I wait a couple of minutes and I try again. Let's see. Let's clear the context and try again. Can you list all the videos about Git commits? This seems not to work. Let's try something different. What age was Key when he started coding? Key started coding at the age of 12. Can you link me the video, please. ASCII number one. Let's try it. That's correct. Very good. So listing seems to be a problem. Let's try if the performance is increased when we use a JSON format. So I delete this file here and upload keycodes video JSON, not beautified. And try this again. Does key have a video about typehints? Yes, that's correct. Can you give me the link to the video? I apologize, coder, but I'm unable to provide direct external links. Okay, so it seems that the unbeautified JSON version is not as structured as it needs to be. So let's try beautified JSON now. Maybe that helps. Save. Let's try again. Does key have a video about typehints? That is correct again. Can you link the video, please? And again. So that is not working as expected. Let's try this again. Can you list all the videos about Git? How to create a pre-commit hook? How to commit better with Git? How to use Git hooks for better commits? Very nice. That's correct. That's correct. And that's correct as well. That's actually very impressive.
Nice.
Let's try to get a summary of the transcript. Can you give me a summary of the video how to commit better with Git? Okay, let's clear the context and try again. I'm actually constantly running into this token limit restriction here. My theory right now is that maybe we need to split up the files so that ChatGPT doesn't need to load all the files into the context to make the summary of one video transcript. Let's split everything up. I prepared another folder here, which is called final for some reason. And in there I have a JSON object per video. So video 1 has title, URL, transcript, and video 9 as well. And now I want to try to upload all of these files and see if the assistant will only access one file instead of all of them. So I go upload, final, I select all the files, and there they go. Save. I don't change the prompt and try again. Can you give me a summary of the video how to commit better with Git? Again. Okay, let's see what's happening here. I open this up and start here. Messages, post runs. So here we see is the instructions prompt. And down here we see that we have one tool, which is retrieval. And all of these are the file IDs. Okay, interesting. Let's try something simpler. In which video does key use Philips Hue? Coder, key use Philips Hue in the video referenced in the document video 3 JSON. Can you link the video, please? Not really.
Computer says no.
Can you provide the URL for this video, please? Okay, there's no direct URL provided in the text of the video file. That's very curious indeed. Having all the separate files is not actually improving performance in any way. We don't get summaries and the URLs are not actually working that well. So let's try something different. This file contains the URL, the title, and a two-sentence summary of each video and a link to the associated transcript file in the final folder. To summarize the transcript, I opened all the transcript files in the transcript folder and send it to GPT 3.5 Turbo and told it to summarize the transcript. You are a YouTube script summarizer which outputs a two-sentence summary of a YouTube video transcript. And then I added a user message with the transcript. All of this I saved to the files here in summary. So you see these are like two-sentence long summaries of the whole video context for each video. This I used to put together this file here. So let's upload this and see if it improves performance. Let's run it again. In which video does key use Philips Hue? That looks valid. Can you provide a link? There's no link here. There is no link. Please output the URL. Here we go. Let's see if that works. And it is not. It's fabricated. In which file do you look for this information? Video 3. Please look at the summary file. We are still running into limit problems here. Maybe we need to adjust the prompt a little to help the assistant access the files better. Files, you are provided with a keycode summaries beautify JSON which provides the title, URL, and summary for each video. Use this first. You are provided with a separate transcript file for each video, the title and the URL. Use this if the summary file is not enough to answer the questions of the user. And then I want to remove this here to keep the answers a little bit shorter. Save, save. What age was Key when he started to program? Age of 12. In which video was it mentioned? Can you add a link to it, please? Certainly. How I became a programmer, my coding journey and tips. That is not a video of mine. Let's see what it is. The future of data visualization from Jeffrey here. That's not me. Okay, this is actually not working and I'm thinking maybe it is because we have too many information for the model to work with. So let's get rid of all of the JSON files other than the summary. What age was Key when he started to program? Can you please provide a link to the video, please? Certainly. How I became a software engineer without a computer science degree. That is not my video as well. So this doesn't seem to work that good, to be honest. I'm a little bit surprised, but maybe JSON is not the optimal format for the GPT-4 Turbo model to work with. I have another file here. This one, key code summary text, is basically the summary with the video URL and the video title, but in a pure text format. So let's upload this and see if it works any better. In which video does Key uses Philips Hue? This is not correct English. So the video title, how to use git commits, Python code included, that's correct. Can you provide a link, please? And that's correct. That worked. Maybe it works better, maybe it does not. Let's try the other one again. What age was Key when he started to program? True. Can you provide a link, please? I apologize, but I cannot provide a direct link. That is not working. Actually, our prompt is not correct, to be honest. You are provided with key code summary beautified JSON. That is not true. You are provided with keycode summary.txt and the other ones you don't have anymore. Let's add something to explain the process of answering the model of thinking. Always look at the keycode summary.txt, not beautify JSON, first and no other file. Only if you don't find the information that you need, look at the other files. We don't have any other files anymore. So let's try this. In which videos does Key talk about Ethereum? Coda! Keycode talks about Ethereum in the following videos. How to implement an ERC-721 token, coding an NFT crypto collectible, and creating a dApp and migrating to the Ethereum mainnet. That's correct, that's my 3-day series. Let's try the usual suspects again. How old was Key when he started programming? And again, can you provide a link, please? Keycode's my software developer journey. Nope. Not correct, sorry. Let's try something different. It seems that the model gets it right at the first time, but when I ask for more information, it screws up. So let's add another rule here. Provide links to the videos for answers mentioning a video or its content. So hopefully this will encourage the model to search for video titles and URLs right from the start. And again, how old was I? Coda! Key started learning programming at the age of 12, that's correct. And that is the video. So this actually helps us a little bit. Let's see if we can list all of the videos. Can you list all the videos on the channel and provide links to them? Coda, here's the list of videos on the Keycode channel with their respective links. Okay, let's see, let's try some. That's correct. Why you should use typehints? I think, yeah, that's correct. And the productivity tips, my very first video ever. That works, but I think one is missing because I actually uploaded transcript and summaries for 19 videos, but good enough. Let's try summarizing again. Can you summarize all of these videos? Let's go. Certainly, Coda. Okay, this is confident now. Here's a summary of each video listed on the Keycode channel. Neural networks, matrix math, and NumPy. Yes. He shares his programming journey starting from when he began programming at the age of 12. That's correct. Still, one video is missing for some reason, but I am impressed right now. It was actually not that hard. All right, as you can see, providing the information in the correct form to make this assistant's API fly is not easy, especially if you have such a low rate limit like I do. Watch this video next to unlock the real power behind this new API and learn how you can integrate this assistant into your web app. Like and subscribe and have a lot of fun, coders!